We will continue our discussion of particle kinematics by taking on an example problem. So, let us take a very simple example to start with. Consider a particle executing motion in one dimension, and we will denote it by a coordinate x. The velocity u is given by u equal to e power minus t meters per second. This is given. The particle, we are told, is at x equal to 0 at time instant t equal to 0, and we are asked to find the acceleration as a function of time. So, let us first draw a schematic showing the system. We first have to make sure we understand who the observer is. The observer in this instance is fixed at the origin, let us say, and we know the particle p is moving with the velocity u instantaneously given by e power minus t meters per second. And we know the relationship between u and x from the earlier discussion. So, this implies dx dt equals e power minus t, and if I integrate both sides of this equation, this says x as a function of time equals minus e power minus t plus an integration constant c. C is what we usually refer to as the integration constant. We are told that x at 0 is 0. This implies e power minus 0 plus the integration constant equal to 0, which again implies minus 1 plus c equal to 0, which also implies c equal to 1. So, from this we know that x of t is 1 minus e power minus t. So, if we now look at the position, this essentially starts at 0. If I plot the position as a function of time, the position starts at 0, and for very long time asymptotically reaches this position 1. So, this is the graph of this. And similarly, if I plot u as a function of time, u is initially 1 and it slows down towards 0. So, this is the graph of u of t equals e power minus t meters per second. Now, this is not the end of the story. We need to find the acceleration as a function of time, which we know is given by du dt. The acceleration in this case is simply differentiating the known velocity by once with respect to time, and that gives me, let us make sure we put the units on all of these quantities. X as a function of time is 1 minus e power minus t meters, and the acceleration is minus e power minus t meters per second squared. So, the acceleration at time instant 0 is really minus 1, and it goes asymptotically towards 0, but always remains negative. Acceleration being negative implies that the system or the particle is decelerating. Okay, so, you are looking at a decelerating particle that is moving to the right of the observer given by here by O. So, this completes the problem statement as far as what was asked. Let us go one step further and ask ourselves the question, can I from this information deduce acceleration as a function of x? Can I write the acceleration as a function of x? So, what that means, let us go back and see what that means. I know x as a function of time, which is given by 1 minus e power minus t meters. So, if I go back to this graph of x as a function of time, and if I want to make the shift of the independent coordinate from time to x, at the moment if I give you a time, I am able to tell you what the corresponding x location would be. That is what this equation tells us. What we want to do is, if I give you a corresponding x location, can I identify a time? If I am able to do this, that is the condition under which I will be able to answer this question. Okay, so let us see if that is possible with this particular example. So, if I said x of t is equal to 1 minus e power minus t, I can rewrite this as x minus 1 equals minus e power minus t, which also implies 1 minus x equals e power minus t. If I take natural logarithm on both sides, 1 minus x equals minus t, or I can write this as simply t equals minus natural logarithm of 1 minus x. In this process, what I have done is I have calculated the inverse of x of t. Okay, this is the mathematical operation that we have performed in these four steps, starting with x equals 1 minus e power minus t. If I am able to do this, as I was in this particular case, then what this allows me to do is, given an x, I can tell you the time instant at which the particle is at that x location. Now, have we completed our discussion of whether I can write A as a function of x? Not really. What we do know is that A is equal to minus e power minus t meters per second squared. We do know this. So, this, and if I now know A, where t itself is a function of x, which is known from the previous inverse operation, inversion of the function x of t, I am able to make that substitution and say minus t equals minus t equals log of 1 minus x. So, this is natural log of 1 minus x e power log of 1 minus x is simply 1 minus x minus 1 minus x . So the acceleration as a function of x is equal to x minus 1 . So this is a much simpler function to deal with than acceleration as a function of time being e power minus t, minus e power minus t. But as it turns out, we were able to get to this step only because we were able to invert x of t. And this inversion of a function may not always be possible. We will look at some examples. Let us say if I simply had a even a harmonic motion with the least simplest of complexity, this kind of an inversion may not be possible. So, this acceleration is now a function of x, the spatial coordinate, and is given by x minus 1. I can also invert u as a function of x, similarly minus log 1 minus x. So, u as a function of x is simply 1 minus x. So, if I choose x, the spatial location of this particle, as the independent coordinate, let us quickly recap. Using time as the independent coordinate, I can either use time as the independent coordinate, in which case I know x as a function of time is 1 minus e power minus t, u as a function of time is e power minus t, and acceleration as a function of time is minus e power minus t. If I use position as the independent coordinate, then u as a function of x is 1 minus x, acceleration as a function of x is x minus 1, and t as a function of x is given by minus natural logarithm of 1 minus x. So this is the enabling step to go from this to this kind of an observation, to go from time as the independent coordinate choice to position. Now, this kind of observation making where I focus on time as the independent coordinate is typically called a Lagrangian frame of making observation, and this is often referred to as the Eulerian frame of making observations. But if I am able to find this t as a function of x from a given x as a function of time, then these two frames of reference, or these two ways of making observations, are interchangeable and they are analogous. We will continue our discussion on kinematics in the next lecture.